Hi friends, research scholars, lecturers, everyone. Today we have to discuss about research. How to conduct research, how to select the topic, research topic, how to cover the introduction part, significance of the study, objectives of the study, statement of the problems, research methodology, hypothesis of the study, scope and limitations of the study, lastly organizations of the study. First of all, we should know about what do you mean by research. Research is a systematic study and gain knowledge and also to search fact about informations or data. Once again, the questions has been arises, what do you mean by data? Data is a group of set of informations we have collected already. Here we have two kinds of data. One is secondary data, another one is primary data. Secondary data in the sense already published government reports, annual reports, half yearly reports, totally published data, statistical data. Primary survey or primary data, researcher can prepare questionnaire, number of questions have been asked to the beneficiary or respondents in this your study area. Here, research, how to select the topics. But today, as we know that we have so many issues or problems has been arises, but as we know that, as we seen in present context today, best example is that agriculture problems or issues, how to solve these problems, how to select the subject as or relevant topics. It is very difficult to select the topic because unless researcher can read more about agriculture development or agriculture issues, particularly the previous literatures, researcher can collect the information and read the literatures properly. Then only he can understand the problems of agriculture. What are the issues? What are the drawbacks? What are the problems of farmers as well as agriculture finance or other kinds of infrastructure facilities? These kinds of the research has been conducted only through knowing a better informations or better reading habits of the research scholars. First of all, researcher can meet expertise in the field of agriculture. Best example is that we have so many agriculture universities, so many experts, particularly for how to deal, how to select the topic on agriculture. Secondly, secondary sector like manufacturing sector or industrial sectors, how industries has been worked and what are the problems or issues has been arises, particularly in industries, what are the issues has been arises, how to solve the problems, what are the policies, what are the programs, what are the strategies has been adopted, how to write a proper solutions to overcome of that particular problems. Even though today many industries has been locked out. Why? Because this industries is not according to Alfred Weber industrial locations theory. If the industries is not established according to Alfred Weber theory, he has been highlighted that he has been considered two aspects. One is location, another one is transportations. One is locations plays a significant role. That area of agglomerations, as we know that Bangalore is, or Delhi, Bombay, Chennai, Calcutta, these are all the metropolitan cities, has been conducted or established a industries, all the raw materials, labor, skilled labor, everyone has been available surrounding the city area. If the industries has been established in district level or taluk levels, it would be very problem to solve or run of the particular industries. Because of problems of raw material, problems of transportations, problems of marketing facilities, problems of advertisements, or people are not aware of that particular product. What product can manufacturing, what product can release marketing to the that particular product into the areas. So that would be very problem for selections of, particularly for selections of the product. Particularly the industrial locations theory, what it tells that industry must be area of agglomerations. That would be available all kinds of infrastructure, including raw materials, labor, capital, other kinds of marketing facilities, everything. Generally, we have to establish industries, then it would be run under the profits. Otherwise, it comes under the laws. In the sense that industries is not established according to Alfred Weber theory. Likewise, service sectors. Say, the best example is that markets. Markets are sandies. As we know that is something. Weekly ones or 50 days ones or monthly ones. According to this service area, service sectors, service centers always located in center place of the city. That's locations has been attracted all the customers in that particular city areas. Then only that industries are a place attract the customers, then only they can earn more profits. Here, research, conducting of research or selections of the topic, it is not easy thing. Only thing, the researcher can read more literatures, newspapers, and also previous experiences and previous research theses. They can read, they can, he or she can understand what are the problems has been going on in present days. Then only they can identify the problems, then they will conduct a research, how to solve that problems. He has some idea. When we can get idea? Because we have to read more literatures or collect more data or publish data. Then we have to read properly, they can understand properly and meet the those who are expertise in the field of that particular area or a subject. You can go and meet him or her, then take some suggestions how to select the topics. What are the topics I can select? And also to fix the study area. First of all, we have to discuss about the research. I already told you that what do you mean by research? Research is a systematic study and gain knowledge and also to search fact. That research topic or a subject, you have to identify the exact the problems of that particular research. Here, say for example, introductions. We have to cover introductions part, some general informations of national level, state level, district level, as well as your study area, either grassroots levels. Suppose researcher, I wanted to advise you, those who are conducting research in the initial stages. First of all, you can go with micro level study. Suppose you can go with micro level study, that would be very easy to identify the problems and also give suggestions. This will be very easy for learning as well as gain knowledge, and also you have to suggest very easily. Suppose you go with state level or national level, this would be very problems for gathering informations, writing the report, analysis and interpretation. It would be very problem, too vast. That would be very macro level. It would be very problems for writing the report of the researchers. So that I advise you sincerely, you have to put effort particularly on read from the grassroots level, micro level study. Then only researcher can understand the situations of that particular subject or a topic. And then you should know what are the importance or significance of that particular studies. Here, the study always plays a significant role. Best example is that now, present situations, COVID-19, coronavirus-19, how it impact on economy, how it impact on political instability, how it declining of agriculture productions, how it would be declining for GDP growth rate, national income or per capita income. This would be the very trendy topic or present topic, very catchy. This is the very challenging also. Best example is that global warming and also globalizations, LPG models, liberalizations, protections and globalizations. What are the issues in WTO, World Trade Organizations? What are the problems has been arises? What are the problems has been still the traders are facing? This kind of the study, it would be very helpful to conduct research or selections of the topic of particular he or she researchers. So that in this sense, you have to, first of all, the present trends, very catchy, very essential, very delicate issues. You can take it as a very challenging, that kind of the topic you can take and tackle the problems, how to tackle, that is very competitive way. Then only we should know what is real research. Then it will comes how to frame the objectives, how to read the research review of literatures, and also how to identify the problems of that particular research. And then you have to frame the objectives. Then we can, as we know that methodology, also known as the art of the research. Methodology, it would be plays a very significant role. This based on our entire thesis is, it's depending upon methodology, which method you can go. Methodology is itself is reveals that method of collecting the data, analyzing the data. It's very simple. Methodology is itself is reveals that method of collecting the data, analyzing the data. Here we have collecting statistical data. Statistics, what do you mean by quantitative? Always also known as quantitative data. Quantitative data are quantitative methods in the sense to study the numeral values. To study the numeral values means in the sense numbers. And also descriptive research. Descriptive is that research, qualitative research means descriptive in the forms. Descriptives in the forms. Here the statistical quantitative methods also includes so many tools and techniques, schedules, questionnaires, so many methods has been used, and also that includes a statistical data. Best example is that literacy of the particular districts, literacy of the particular states or national level. It is in the number and also identify in percentage, either in decadal wise or annual systems. Only thing is that we should know, researcher can understand which methodology we can go, which methodology we can adopt. That would be main thing of the research. Researcher can select which methodology we can adopt. We can go. Either we can go with both primary and secondary, or either we can go with secondary only or primary only. But both the method, that would be good research or to identify the problems and solve the problems, and also we have to give some policy implication or strategies. And also another important aspect is scope and limitations. You have to limit your durations according to your time. You have to fix time limits. It is based on your budget, time, everything. Scope and limitation. You have to choose the study area, and also durations. Based on that, you have to fix the research. Lastly, chapterizations. According to that, you have to classify 5, 6, 7 or 8 chapters. It is depending upon your study, your subject. Based on that, we have to classify the different topics, different chapter schemes. This is something about the research, how to conduct a research, how to select a topic, how to identify the problems, how to frame totally the proposed work plan, means blueprint of your research. You have to, what I sincerely suggest you, that you have to read more and more literatures, news, okay, India national level or international level news. That would be very essential for writing identifications of the problems, and also some we have to write the suggestions of that particular subject or a topic. So that, in the sense, first of all, we have to identify the problems. Particularly, how we have to identify, because this would be very easy for reading habits, collections of the data, collections of the information. Then you have to write, identify the problems or issues of that particular subject. This is something about research. What do you mean by research? Meaning of research. How to select the topic. Before selecting of the topic, you have to read more on secondary information or a published data. Then only you have to get so many ideas to frame the topic. That would be very trendy. Best example is that COVID-19. This is for example only. Likewise, you have to identify your respective subject, respective area, your specializations. This is something about the research. How to select the topic, how to identify the problems, how to frame the objectives, and also how to write the methodological parts, how to write scope and limitations of that particular study, and also lastly chapterizations, chapter schemes. It is based on your subject or a topic. This is something about the research. So you have to understand. Hope you understand very well. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon, then you can get subscription, and I hope you more benefited. Any suggestions, you are welcome. Meet you next class. Thank you very much.